Hey guys, so here's what I think about self-motivation. I think self-motivation is tough fucking work. Okay, I won't censor myself, and I think it deserves that kind of profanity, just to express that it is that tough self-motivation. And it's from everything, you know, everything that we need to get ourselves to doing. There's always this tension between, I want to do this, but then the other side of the coin is, I need to do this. Want versus need. I think that's always in a constant struggle, with me personally at least, and, you know, just observing and witnessing other people around me, it seems to be that case with many other people as well. Motivating oneself is work, and it's challenging, I think. Especially, I'm a social work intern in a high school setting, and I work with ninth grade students. I provide counseling and group therapy services to ninth grade students. And I primarily work with four clients. And, you know, just looking at them, it's really apparent that, you know, self-motivation is a challenge. I think that can be, it's hard to argue against that. I think maybe some people, it comes naturally, and doing things that are necessary for them is easy. At least for me, it's not the case. For me, even just waking up in the morning to go somewhere, that's tough. It's tough because, I mean, falling asleep is tough too. A lot of Americans in this country have sleeping problems. They have insomnia issues. They can't fall asleep. Falling asleep is tough work too. And a lot of times I have that issue. So falling asleep is tough. Sleep is great. It's good resting time. And then I have to wake up. I open my eyes, and unfortunately, when I wake up, the first feeling I get isn't like, oh, I feel so refreshed, or, oh my gosh, I had such great amount of sleep, I'm now ready to go outside into the world and do things. I wish that was the first feeling I get, but it's usually kind of like, oh, 10 more minutes, please, or it's 7 o'clock already? What the freak? Like, you know, kind of like that. That's the grogginess I feel in the morning. I'm definitely not a morning person. When I worked at a homeless shelter for a year, I had an overnight shift where I worked from midnight to 8 in the morning, and that was my preferred shift. So having to work 9 to 5, it's really messing with me. But in any case, waking up is hard. But it's because we do it so many times, perhaps, even though it's challenging, it's something I'm used to doing. It's just like, just pick myself up and just like, okay, I know you want to call out sick, but you really can't. That's not an option. Come on, David. Let's get out of bed, take a shower, drink some coffee. Come on, take the bus and go and do the work. At the work setting, for me, it's more like, it's easy to motivate myself. Because I'm there at work. I know what I'm supposed to do. And I'm passionate about the work that I'm doing. I enjoy the work that I'm doing. Social work is my passion, and I plan it to be a lifelong passion. I can see that for the kids in the school, it's hard for them to stay motivated in school because they don't want to be there. You know, they don't enjoy school, a lot of them. They don't even want to write. They don't want to read. They don't want to do the things that they're supposed to do as students. Right, so I get that. I was like that as a student too. I didn't want to do things. Personally, me as a student, I actually, younger, was super motivated. But that's a different version of me that was in the past, I think. I think the future version of me is so much different than the past version of me. It's weird. Anyway, at work, at internship, at a job, in that kind of setting, it's easier for me to be motivated because I think there's an external source of motivation. It's not just me motivating myself, but I'm surrounded by colleagues and coworkers and clients. There's expectations. There's in that setting, I know exactly what I need to do, and I need to do it, even though I might not want to. But generally, I enjoy the work that I do. There's only a few kind of things that I really kind of dread doing. Drafting psychosocial assessments, for example, don't really like doing those, but I have to. But I only had to do a very few amounts so far. But the problem for me is when I come home. right? When I come home, the source of motivation is all on me. The only way, the only motivation that I have is within me. And it's really hard to kind of just push myself. That's been my case. And it was the toughest thing starting this year. I did not start this year very well. In fact, I think my supervisor got quite upset with me about twice, I think. I hope not more. I think it was about twice because I didn't turn my process recordings in time. Process recording is another matter for me. But, you know, so, yeah. So she actually said kind of like, this is not okay. It's not okay. This is not okay. And you haven't even started school yet, right? Well, my internship starts, we had a winter break, and then I have internship for 3 weeks, and then after 3 weeks, my second semester of graduate school begins again. So in that span of 3 weeks, she's just like, you haven't started school again. So what's going on? This is your pretty much your only obligation. She's right. But she's wrong to assume, I think, that because I don't have school, that when I start school, it would be worse for me. Because I think when I started school, that had me more motivated, oddly enough. You know, I have more work. You know, I'm going to classes. I have all this to read. But now I have all these expectations and obligations just pushing on me. There's more external source of motivation. So I'm pushed to do it. So after I started school, like, that wasn't as big of an issue anymore. I'm doing much better now. I'm always busy. It feels like I have no time for anything anymore. It's like there's not enough hours in the day to do things. That's the feeling I get a lot. But you know, that's also a part of being a graduate student within the full-time internship, or actually part-time. But yeah, so I'm not at the level where I want to be in terms of motivation. I'm still dealing with a lot of kind of personal issues and mental stress issues, but it's actually why I just recently started seeing a therapist. It's my first time actually ever in life to receive a counseling session. Kind of ironic considering that I am a social work student providing counseling sessions to high school students. Yeah, I've never been on the receiving end. I've never been a client before in this regard. It's kind of unsettling. I now understand, I can empathize what my clients are feeling when they're receiving counseling. So it's a pretty unsettling thing to kind of open your heart out to kind of, I don't know. I had one session, and in that one hour, I think I just unloaded so much of my shit to the therapist. It was just like, boom, here you go. That's me. Or at least 10% of my issues. Boom. I know it's a lot, but here you go. Whatever you do with it, let's meet next session. You know, it's crazy. But the therapy was really helpful. I think that's helpful to me. What was unsettling was the intake. Being asked, like, these are the questions I ask too as a social work intern. But being asked that is a whole another matter itself. You know, like, do you have like depression, and have you thought about killing yourself or hurting others? These are the questions we end up asking in our profession, but being asked that itself is it's definitely unsettling. And it was unsettling to me, especially after the phone interview intake. Doing the intake on the phone itself is weird. That's awkward and unsettling, but it's just like, I keep going over like, I don't think I should have said that way. I think I revealed too much, or I, you know, like, so pretty unsettling to be a client. One last thing I'll say about self-motivation is this for me. I think growing up for me, motivation was kind of derived from competing with others around me. I always, you know, it's about getting better grades than everyone, getting better test scores, jumping higher for longer, running faster, doing better on getting a higher score on this video game. Always about competing against others. And when I was a kid, I considered myself pretty good. You know, I was I did pretty good, and I think that's what made me motivated, you know, being competent in that kind of competitive setting. But the older you grow up, the more people you meet. And the more people you meet, the more you realize how much better they are at stuff than you. Competition doesn't really become viable anymore on certain things. You know, I used to be the best violinist in fifth grade. And then come 10th grade, I'm like, you know, at the 10th chair of second violin. It's not even a competition anymore for me. I can no longer go further. So for me, growing older, it's the realization that I can't compete. You know, if I do, then I'm going to be in a losing place. I don't want to compete. So growing older now, I realize maybe in the younger years I competed against others. But now the motivation really comes when I'm competing against myself. My doubts, my insecurities, my laziness for one, my fighting against my wants that are not necessarily aligned with my needs. That's the kind of competition that I'm in currently. And I would assume I would be in that kind of competition until pretty much I die. You know, it's going to be a lifelong process, this self-motivation. And I think that's what makes it so tough. It's not like I motivate myself to do this one thing and that's it. Oh my gosh, I succeeded. No, it's just like I got to keep doing it and keep going harder and harder and keep doing it until I get to the point that I need to be at. And then I still got to keep maintaining that. That's the challenge of self-motivation. And that's why I say self-motivation is tough fucking work.